How to create a heart graphic in Adobe Illustrator. Hey guys, Kerry Hawkins here with another VectorMade.com tutorial today. Since it's close to Valentine's Day, we're going to be doing a heart graphic, but we're going to give it some more three-dimensional depth by adding gradients. And it won't actually be a 3D. I've got some 3D tutorials out there, but this one's all flat, two-dimensional. It's just going to give the appearance of 3D using gradients. So let's jump in. I'm going to start with my pen tool. You can hit hotkey P. Make sure you've got a stroke. I like black. I've got it set to 1. This is an 8.5 by 11 if you want to do something similar. Click here, and then you'll get this preview for your next point that you want to make. And just hold shift so that it's directly above. What we're doing is kind of creating the center of the heart, and I'll show you why, because we're only going to do half of it for now. But go ahead and click here, create that second point. Maybe this needs to be about here, and just set that curve. Now, if you like where that curve is set, but you know that the next curve isn't going to be as severe, you can hold shift to keep this in line like this, and then hold alt to only affect the next curve. Like this, but if I let go of alt, you'll see it's going to both sides get affected by an equal amount. But I want the curve to be about there on the right side, and then on the left side, hold on, let me adjust that again. On the left side, I don't want it to be as strong because we're going to add another point about here, and I'm holding shift again to just keep this straight up and down, and then come in here and click on where it says anchor to finish the shape. And we'll probably do something like that. Now, I don't like the way that looks 100%. I'm gonna come in here with A, which is my direct selection tool, hotkey A. And you can select this one and either just shift it up with the arrow key. You can hit shift and arrow key to move it up by a factor of 10, or just once without the shift held down, and it will just move it by a smaller increment. Now I like that position, but I want to grab this handle and bring it down, and I'm holding shift to keep it still in line. I want it perfectly vertical. So I held shift there, and I'm going to come in here and probably grab this handle, again clicking and dragging to select this anchor, and then grab this handle. Let's see what that looks like. I'm gonna just shift this down a little bit more and maybe grab both of these and shift them down just a little bit. And then maybe just grab that one and shift it over to the right just a hair. I like that. I think that looks fine. Now, I'm going to swap my fill and my stroke like so. You can also hit shift X if you want to do the hotkey. I'm going to click and drag while holding shift and alt. Shift keeps it in the horizontal line, and then alt creates a copy. You're going to right click on that and hit transform, reflect. You want to make sure vertical and preview are selected. Say okay. And now you've got two pieces. You're going to select both of them by clicking and dragging, and then click on the inside of the one that's to the left or the one that you first made. It doesn't really matter in this instance, but normally it does. Align, go to your align tab. If you don't see that, it's under window align. And while this should have a thicker blue outline to it, or whatever color it is that you're using to indicate a selection, it may be different than blue. I think default is blue. And then just click on this horizontal distribute space button here in align, and they should snap together. And if they don't, you might have a setting other than 0. So if it says 1 inch here like that, it might do that. So make sure that it says 0 before you do that. Okay, they're now together next to each other with no space, but they're not connected. So we're going to go to Pathfinder. Again, window, Pathfinder if you don't see it. Have it both things selected and click the first one, which is Unite. And you'll see that line in the middle go away. And just to show you, I'm going to Shift X just to show you that it's all one shape. You can also do Control Y to look at outline mode and see that it is definitely just one shape. All right, now with that selected, I'm going to come in and make a gradient, and I've already done this, but I'm going to show you what it looks like. So what you'll do is just kind of make a gradient where you have light red on the edges and darker red on the inside. And you want, for purposes of this tutorial, you kind of want two of these darker reds in the middle. And just to show you what I've got, I'm clicking on this. This is 100-100 on magenta and yellow to create CMYK red. Now you can do RGB as well, and in that case you're just gonna, you know, bump this all the way up. But I always work in a lot of print stuff, so I tend to be CMYK based. But whatever color setting you're gonna use is fine. And for this one I did, I just added 25 cyan and 25 black. Now, if you're not sure how to get these in here, let me just back that up and recreate it for you. Gradient, if you ever click on gradient, and we're in a linear gradient, make sure you're there. It's gonna have two, by default, two swatches here. And you can just click and drag to add more from up here, like so. And then just click these circles to reposition them. And so we're gonna go like this, 25 and 25. And then we'll just click and drag here. You can replace ones that you've already made, or you can add new ones like so. And if you add too many, you can click and drag away to delete. So click, drag away, and you delete. Let's back up. But you basically want it to look like this, where it's light on the edge, and dark in the middle. We'll come back and adjust it later, but that's the gist for now. Now, go ahead and copy this with Control C and paste it to the front with Control F. Now I've got two of them here, and I'll click that away just so you can see there are two hearts perfectly on top of each other. What you want to do is fill that with red. So fill selected, and just fill it in with a solid red. That's it. Again, let me show you. We've got two, the solid reds on top. With this one, I'm going to cut out some sections of it so that we have some interest. And I'm going to do that with the pen tool, again, hotkey P if you need it. And just click somewhere outside here and come to about where this curve starts, something like that. You can make your own decision here, but I'm going to go about here. And I'm clicking and dragging to create a curve. And I'm also going to change this over to a stroke and just do white so I can see where I'm going inside of the heart. But somewhere about here looks good. And then maybe something like this. Let's see how that looks. And actually, just to be on the safe side, I'm going to extend that out past the heart shape. And the reason I do that is because I'm going to cut these out later, and I want to make sure that they're separated. So let's see, how does that look? That looks okay. I think that will do. You know, you can come in here. I'm just using A, my direct selection tool, again, to adjust these sections so that they are exactly the way I want them to be. Maybe I do like that instead. Maybe this comes, oops, I grabbed the wrong one. And if I'm backing up, I'm just, you know, Control Z to back up a step. It's a hotkey that's very useful. But I might do something like this. Let's just get it good enough. I like it. We'll go. Now we're going to use the pen tool again, create another shape here. I'm clicking outside and then coming to kind of where this anchor is, and I'm going to kind of go along with that same curve if I can, and maybe do something like this. Maybe that's not enough. Maybe I should come up here and maybe that looks good. Yeah, that'll be cool. I think that's fine. If you don't like it, again, you can go and change those as much as possible. All right. We're going to select this. We're going to hit shift and select this to add that to the selection, holding shift while you click, and do the same thing with the heart in the background. Now all three are selected. I've got the heart and these two strokes. I'm going to come over to my Pathfinder and click the first Pathfinder's divide. When I do that, it creates three shapes, but they are all grouped. So right click and say ungroup. Now, they should not all be selected at once if you did it correctly. Go ahead and grab this and delete it grab this one and delete it as well. And you can see it's already starting to have some really fun depth, but still looks like the same traditional heart shape, because all we have is basically this shape on top of the heart shape. And we're covering up some of the middle gradient. And the gradient makes it look like there's sort of a natural shadow behind our lighter red. But to adjust this, you're going to want to use your selection tool to grab the heart in the background, come over here to where your gradient fill is, and you can adjust things here, or you can click your gradient tool and adjust them on the object, which I prefer to do it this way because you can be more precise with things. So all I'm doing is clicking and dragging from one edge to the next at an angle. And then after it's done, I'm going to pull this so that there's more of a shadow on this side and maybe less of a shadow on this side. But I still want a good shadow. And I might even bring in my light red a little bit. You can do that if you want a little more connection here, a little more blending there. You can bring this guy back up here if you want to. You can mess with these sort of diamond shapes are the blend in between these two circles. So you've got, this is the blend between these two. This is the blend between these two. Makes sense? So if you click on just this and drag it, it's not going to affect the position of the light or the dark red. It's just going to affect the transition. So do you want that a harsh transition or do you want it softer? So there's lots of cool things to mess with here. Like I may make this harsher on that end and do the same thing over here. Maybe make this harsher and maybe bring it in just a little bit. And maybe bring this in just a little bit. Something along those lines. So maybe it's less severe. Actually, I kind of like it a little bit more severe. So I'm going to back up just a little and affect this again. I'm going to pull this away and maybe bring that back out a little more. I like a little bit more of a shadow. I think it looks cool. So anyway, there it is. And let's just do a quick bonus. Let's say you wanted to add a shape just to make it even more interesting. Let's add with the pen tool. We're going to grab this and kind of cut through the middle of the heart like that. I'm going to go ahead and create let's get rid of my gradient fill. I just want black. And I'm going to go to stroke and probably bump this up to 10, maybe 20. Let's do 20. While you're in stroke, you want to make sure that you can see options. It may say hide options, and you may want to click show options so that you get all of this stuff down here. It should have arrowhead options. For the first one, you're going to want to have like probably this. Okay, yep, we want that to be the tail. And then for the arrowhead, maybe just, you know, select one of these. Sure. Now, I tend to find that like the scale of these is too big usually. So it's going to start at 100% naturally. If you want, you can bump this down. I'm just going to hit shift and the arrow key down to drop it to 50. And same thing for the top, go to 50. I like the way that looks. Now, just know that if you increase the stroke weight, it's going to keep these proportionate. So if I go to 30, they're still 50%, 50%. Makes sense? Actually, I kind of like the way 30 looks. I'm going to go with 30. And I don't want this on top. I want to have the red, solid red piece that we cut out of the middle on top. So I've selected it, and I'm going to go Control Shift, right bracket to bring it to the front. And that means that this gradient heart's in the background, the arrow is in the middle, and this part is in the top. I'm going to go ahead and click on my arrow graphic, and I want it to be a little bit further outside, but I want this end to come out further. So I've got direct selection tool selected. I'm going to click and drag to get this point, and I'm just going to click and drag it out until it's in a spot where I like it. So maybe about there. I think that looks fine. And then if you want to even add a little bit more depth to this, you can copy and drag this. Again, Shift and Alt to make a copy. The Shift is just to keep it in line, right? I don't want, without Shift, it can just go anywhere. But I want it to be in a nice line here. And just click and drag that. I'm going to go to Transparency, change that to Multiply. And I'm going to drop this down to maybe 30%. And I also want this to be a little bit snugger, to like more snug to the original. Something like that. Maybe even more. Just something along those lines to give an idea that like it's slightly above the heart graphic in the back. And if you want to, you can also take this and apply go to Effect Stylize Feather and click Preview and see what that is. That's going to be too much. Let's try 0.1, 0.2. But 0.1 looks good at this size. Just mess with the radius until it gets something that's desirable here. But all that does is softens up the edge. It's still going to be a vector, but it's sort of applying a raster effect so that it's not a 100% hard edge here. It's feathered. So you might do that also to create some interest. But there you go. There's a heart graphic using a simple shape, but we're adding some depth using gradients only. Anyway, let me know what you guys thought of that tutorial. I hope you have a wonderful Valentine's Day, whether you've got somebody or not. And I will see you guys in the next video.